Hey, Jason Morrell here. There's a type of chart available in Excel called the radar chart. It's been around for quite a while. Not many people use it, but it's very good for showing anomalies or outliers in your data. It does this by plotting a shape, and any irregularities in the shape will show you where these outliers or anomalies are. Here's a demonstration. In this example, we have a fairly large table showing the monthly rainfall between 2017, month by month. So I'm first going to choose all the cells across the top for the years. That'll be the labels for my radar chart. I'm also going to hold Control and click the latest information. So Control lets you select two non-adjacent ranges. That's two ranges that aren't next to each other for use for our chart. I then go to Insert at the top, go to my charts gallery here, and find the radar chart. Now there's a few different options. I'm just going to stick with the basic one to start with. And also, to see more detail, I'm going to move it to its own chart by going to the Chart Tools Design tab, going to Move Chart on the right-hand side, and put it on a brand new sheet. So let's call that Radar. Now, at the moment, the chart is configured the wrong way around. So I'm going to go across to Switch Row and Column, and it transformed into a proper radar chart. The reason it didn't give you the right chart initially was because normally you select data that goes in columns, whereas we chose two rows within the table. So we just switched it around to swap the rows and the columns on the chart. Now, if you look, we've got concentric circles, starting with the lower values in the middle through to the highest values on the outside. The idea of a radar chart is that if your data falls into the natural range of data that you'd normally expect, you get a fairly regular shape in your radar chart. So most of the stuff here falls between about 100 and 150 all the way around, except for this anomaly that we've put in there. This little data point here is 250, which is way out of the normal range. So as you can see, it spikes out. It would show the same thing if you had a really low value. Like if one particular month you had, say, 10 millimeters, it would come right down to the center of the diagram here and kind of spike right in. And again, you could spot it fairly quickly because it disfigures the normal shape you'd expect to see. At the top here under Chart Tools Design, you can hover over any of these, or you can click on a design to keep it. And that's just a quick way to get different designs, different color schemes, different layouts, and other options. For this particular chart, to finish it off, you probably set the chart title to something descriptive. So if you just click in there and rename it, so this would be December rainfall between 2000 and 2017. The legend here, okay, there's only one series of data, so there's no real point having the legend here. If you were showing 2 months worth of data, say November and December for all those years, you'd have two series here and two different colored shapes on your radar. That'd be worth keeping the legend for. In this particular case, I'm gonna click on the chart, go to my plus sign, which shows all the chart elements, and switch off the legend. It's serving no purpose on this particular chart. The other thing I may want to do here is to add the actual data values on each data point. You can see the years going around the wheel, around the edge here, from 2000 through to 2017. But it may be worth including that information, or at least the values, on the shape itself. So under Data Labels, if I click the arrow and choose More Options, this gives me a side panel. And straight away you can see the values next to each of the data points on your radar. You may on occasion also want to include category name. So in this case that would show the year and the value. In this case, I think because you've got it around the edge, less clutter is better. So I'll probably switch that off in this instance. Let's do one quick example where we add another month in. So if you go to the Chart Tools Design tab and select Data, it throws us back to the original sheet and shows us the data that's already selected. It also gives you this box here. And you can use the box here if you want to add extra ranges in. But the easiest way I find is just to go straight back to the data and select the extra data that you need. So you've got your first two already. I'm going to hold down Control again, and maybe I'll choose something mid-year. So if I choose this range as well, right through to the last year, it's called Series 1 and Series 2. If you want to modify those, you just choose Edit here, and each of those series you can name. So the B9 through to SS9, that'll be June. This one here, I'm going to edit that, and that's December. Click OK, and take a look at your chart. And if we just quickly turn the legend on, because we turned it off before, go to the plus sign, tick on the legend, and the legend's actually gone down the side, but you can reposition that if you want to. But the important bit is that you've now got two shapes on your radar. You'll notice that because we had the data values on, there's now too much clutter really in the middle of the chart. So in this instance, I'd undo the data labels just to simplify that as well. So that's the radar chart. And like I say, it's very good for spotting anomalies. As long as you've got regular data, you should have fairly regular shapes, and that's the idea. But if there's something that doesn't fit the normal range, it'll spike out or it'll spike in, but you'll spot it.
So that's all there is to it. My name is Jason Morrell. Thanks for watching.